Hello everyone and welcome to another game of World of Warships. Today we are watching Odalir and I'm sorry, I have no idea how to pronounce that nickname. I'm sorry if I'm getting it wrong. Now he is in his warspite, the Year 6 British battleship. He is on the map fault line in a 3-point domination game mode and it's a Tier 6 battle. There are no carriers, but there are quite a few enemy destroyers, so we shall see how that turns out. Now I got this replay from wowreplays.com and I will put a link in the video description as usual. Also, I wanna say Wargaming has released a trailer commercial, let's call it a commercial for World of Warships recently. It's very short, it's like 40 seconds long or something, and it's hilarious. I think I'll put a link to that in the description as well. Just, it's fun. So I'd recommend you watch that. Now, let's take a look how this battle is starting. We have few ships here going towards C and the majority is driving towards A. The team has discussed some strategy and they wanna get A and B first. Now there is a lone destroyer, I think, going for B. And yeah, it's usual that the battleships wanna go towards A. There is some open space here to maneuver. If you go somewhere like C, you are stuck in a channel. And if enemy destroyers just shoot torpedoes down this channel, you're pretty much screwed because there is not much room to maneuver and it's easy to predict where you're gonna be because you are channel. While over here at A, there is just a lot more room to maneuver. Also, once you actually have C, you either have to take the long way, get back to some other point, or you go towards this channel, which is very small. While at A, you have at least a bit of a larger channel to travel towards B. So I guess it's a good tactic. They want to take A first and then probably push with their main force towards B. Now they actually managed to capture C, which is great. Those ships might have to retreat depending on how many ships the enemies are committing. But they have destroyers here with some cruiser support and that's exactly what you want at C. Have anything there. And here we see the first salvo fire that an enemy cruiser and yeah. One hit, one citadel. Yeah. Off to a great start, I completely agree. Now the friendly destroyer at B was pushed back, so they are losing that point. It's not looking so great at A, but with the massive force incoming, they should take A, even if it takes a bit longer. Now those destroyers are probably trying to intercept some of the battleships here. Looks like the enemies are might be committing quite a force to actually get C. So I think this cruiser might be better off just retreating, trying to go towards the main fleet here. Now the Warspite has quite limited range for a battleship, 16.3 kilometers. He is currently He was using his spotting aircraft to extend the range. Unfortunately, the Warspite cannot mount a module to increase the range of the main batteries. The New Mexico, for example, can. And I'm not exactly sure when it happened that they introduced this module. But, you know, it makes the New Mexico, I think, quite a bit better. But the Warspite is still a decent ship. Our Warspite here is slowly approaching A. Those ships, I think they are waiting for reinforcements and once they are all gathered, they will hopefully push together and decisively take A. C is under attack. I Don't think those ships will be able to hold that point for long. Meanwhile, the destroyer who in the beginning tried to capture B and wisely retreated when he saw that he was numbered is now back, and yeah, he took that point. Nicely done by him. Now if they can't take A with this fleet, it doesn't really matter if they lose C. In a domination game mode, you usually just want to hold the majority of the points. You don't have to hold all. You're spreading yourself too thin usually if you try to contest every point. And again, later in the game, you can maybe take a single ship and try to backdoor or just sneak in and one of the enemy points. But in the beginning, it's usually better if you concentrate your ships on like 2 points. Now it looks like the defenders here are mostly dealt with, or maybe all of them are dead or running away. And the friendly fleet is just pushing in hard. Let's hope that they will all just drive through this channel towards B, because I'm guessing B will under attack pretty soon. Yes, there is already a cruiser. And one destroyer can only do so much to hold this point. Now, those two guys over here at C, they have, and they are still are, defending this point. Looks like they just reset the capture points of someone, so they are doing a good job at delaying the enemy. It's a losing battle. They cannot hold this point against so many enemies, but they can delay them. Also, something else, I want to take this opportunity to welcome all the new subscribers and thank all of my subscribers. My channel has been growing quite nicely recently. I'm always happy to see new people and always happy if people enjoy the content I produce. I'm over 300 subscribers now, and well, I guess for 500 I might be doing something. Gosh, I'm thinking about stream to celebrate if I reach 500. But anyway, thank you all guys, you are amazing. Now let's take a look at the battle again. They've lost B, they've lost the defenders at C, but the remaining team is now pushing towards B, and that's just beautiful to watch. Too often you see a battleship that's like sitting back at the zone wall, or that just then tries to take the long route. But at the moment they are behind. In order to get back into this game, they need to take B and yeah, maybe kill some enemies. And they're just sticking together with one massive push. You see all the battleships driving through this channel. Nobody takes half an hour to make a detour. And I think so far the team has played rather well together. They started discussing tactics in the beginning. Now there are some people here who are complaining they didn't get any support at C. But you know, from the very beginning the team said they want to focus on A and B. And yet the friendly team has been around A for a long time, so it was clear that there were no reinforcements coming. Well, there is an enemy battleship who is kindly enough sending his broadside. And we can also see there is an enemy destroyer inside B that could be a problem. There is only one friendly destroyer left and three enemies. The friendly destroyer is here a bit to the north. There is also a New Mexico showing broadside, and they will hopefully be able to focus her down rather quickly. Now the enemies, they aren't really committing to the defense here, they are trying to go around here. And that's great, because that gives the friendly team an opportunity to just swoop in and take that point. There are still enemy destroyers inside. And those destroyers are really scary if they have the backup of all of those ships. But if those ships decide to go down here in the south, then well, half of them will have islands blocking their shots. So I think the enemy team is making a crucial mistake here. They just stayed here and met this assault head on. It's and a much bigger chance. Considering the secondaries are opening up, I'm guessing he is using the modules to increase the secondary gun range. There is also a flag, I think, that buffs the secondaries. And captain skill. Now, this is a bit of a scary situation. There is some smoke. We know there are destroyers here inside the cap circle. And you know what? Those battleships, they are going in anyway. Friendly team cannot afford to not take B. When you look here, points wise, ship wise, they are behind. They are not winning this by sitting in the back and hoping for a miracle. They will win this game by aggressively taking this point. And, well, Podalia here is trying not to get too close. He is inside the capture circle right now. He's probably waiting for the smoke to clear, and there it is. The destroyer is spotted. Let's hope the team can take him out. And yep, that's a destroyer dealt with. Now they are finally starting to capture this point. There's a destroyer coming in from behind. That could be quite troublesome. Now this Molotov is showing broadside, so he is like an ideal target. On the other hand, the destroyer is probably far more dangerous. We decided to go for the cruiser, and that was a nice hit, so it paid off. The secondaries, or maybe the next salvo, can hopefully finish off the cruiser, and not just some friendly ship can finish off the cruiser. Then he can concentrate on that Clemson. Yep, the cruiser is dealt with. Also keep in mind, in a replay you cannot see if he's focusing the secondaries on one ship. Probably is, but unfortunately things like that do not show up in replays. Now he is maneuvering here, he's trying to keep his distance to that Clemson, and I'm not sure why there is a lone torpedo coming here, but so far it's in good. The teams are pretty equal right now, and that doesn't look good. Now the Warspite is not turning that well. The moment he saw the torpedoes, there wasn't much he could have done. Thankfully, the range of those torpedoes wasn't enough. Well, for some of the torpedoes. So he's still somewhat okay here health-wise. And that was a good shot. The Clemson is still. Now it's 3 friendlies against 2 enemies, although the friendly destroyer is almost dead, I think. He started to fire. Yes, now he was firing high explosive because he was engaging that destroyer earlier. He has switched back to armor piercing. And yeah, the friendly destroyer is gone. It's two battleships against two battleships. The enemies have a New Mexico and New York, I think. The friendlies have the Warspite and a New York. So, ship-wise, pretty equal. I'm not exactly sure how it's HP-wise, considering the enemies. Now, they do control two capture points. The enemy only has one. The enemy still has a bit of lead in points, so it's pretty close. And there is the enemy New Mexico. Unfortunately, the friendly New York is currently in a kind of bad position. He's showing broadside. But so is the enemy New Mexico, and the New Mexico is firing at the Warspite, which is pretty good news currently. Now the enemy has fired. He is turning his ship to fire his rear guns. After that, he will probably turn back again. Yep. Also, the secondary seem to have started a fire, which is also great news. He just got Confederate, and the New Mexico is now focusing the New York. The New York is also angling his armor, but he took a big hit. This is a very intense match. Now, thankfully, the second enemy battleship is still behind an island and cannot currently help. Oh, the New Mexico is trying to focus down the New York. He's still presenting broadside. And the friendly New York is angled rather well, but it did not help. He was too low. And very nicely done. Enemy battleship destroyed. There is only one enemy left. I think it's in New York. And, well, friendly Warspite is still a bit over half health. Oh, the enemy New York is badly damaged and he is showing broadside, so this salvo might as well win the game. Well, it doesn't, but almost. So, found it to be a very exciting match. And pretty soon, I guess, this will be a very deserved victory. He's still alive. Come on. There you go. So let's take a look at the results. Odalir managed to get 2438 base experience and 5 kills. It was certainly well played by him, and I think it was well played by the team in general. They discussed a plan in the beginning, which is nice to see. They decisively took A, took them a while to get there, and then they stuck together and pushed. There were no ships running away and hiding in a corner. The battleships were in the front, and in the end, a decisive push won them the game. The enemies started off pretty well, I guess, but they just, yeah, they didn't commit really to defending B. Instead, they scattered a bit, had half of their fleet behind islands where they could not contribute to the battle, and ultimately they lost. But it was a pretty close and exciting game, I think. And I also think that it showed some really nice teamwork. And I just love to see that in World of Warships. Now when we take here a look at results, it's almost 150,000 damage. Lots of medals, Dreadnought, Kraken, High Caliber, First Blood, close quarter expert confederate, I think. Yeah. It was a beautiful game to watch, I think. I hope you enjoyed it as well. And I see you guys next time.